Lord of the Rings, Fellowship of the Ring, was a movie that just dominated in the year that it came out, which I think was like 2001. No, it had to have been later than that. Maybe more like 2005. What does it matter? If you haven't seen this one, you know about it. It's the first of the big Lord of the Rings movies, the first of the live action. We're going to try and ignore the Ralph Bakshi animated, but the live action Lord of the Rings trilogy. You've got your Elijah Wood, you've got your Ian McKellen, you've got all of those characters. You know, Orlando Bloom is here. Sean Bean, pre Game of Thrones. Sean Bean is here. And listen, this is a movie that when it came out, I really loved. And I certainly was enthusiastic to buy. It's a 3-hour movie, and I was enthusiastic to buy the extended cut DVD that was like 4 hours, because you could not get enough them little hobbits. Now, in the years since it came out, I have not revisited it in a long time, and my opinion of it has somewhat soured. Not for any particular reason, I think, beyond just sort of its enduring popularity, making it see, you know, that kind of, well, I guess everybody likes it, I guess it's not that cool, that kind of a thing. And also just the fact that those hobbit movies, the new ones, are not that great. So when you watch the Hobbit movies, it almost colors your view of the Lord of the Rings movies. Plus, I do think, in retrospect, those extended editions are a little bit of a mistake. There is, you know, such a thing as too much of a good thing. And when you think about watching a Lord of the Rings movies, 3 hours is already a lot. But to think about, oh my goodness, 4 hours, that's a heap. That is a heap. That said, this first one, Fellowship of the Ring, to my mind, was always the better of them. The Return of the King might be the big Oscar winner, but I always found Fellowship to be the most engrossing and, in its way, somewhat self-contained and easier to watch on its own. So all of that is a very long-winded way of saying that I had not seen this movie in quite some time. So when I sat down to rewatch it recently, very pleasantly surprised. This movie is awesome in that sort of old-fashioned sense of the word. It is awe-inspiring. The level of craft and production at play here is really tremendous, and it makes a movie that is not only exciting and involving, but also just gorgeous to look at. It's also a movie that makes voiceover work. Voiceover is oftentimes sort of a red-headed stepchild in the movie industry, and there are a number of times when voiceover doesn't work at all. And voiceover has become very derided as a sign of lazy screenwriting. Here, though, there's that wonderful opening voiceover that must last for a solid 15 minutes that introduces you to the world of Middle-earth. It's Cate Blanchett in these beautiful measured tones delivering it. And it really is, you know, to my mind, a really memorable part of the movie, a favorite part of the movie for me, even though it is basically a history lesson. Lord of the Rings, Fellowship of the Ring, it's a very easy movie to underestimate, but I think that doing so is a mistake. It is a very gripping movie, whether we're talking about the early scenes of fleeing the Nazgul or that terrific sequence in the mines of Moria fighting the cave troll and then escaping over that bridge with all the arrows flying everywhere and then that Balrog thing. This really is a terrific movie that I am going to give 4 big stars to. And don't forget to visit our website, northmetrotv.com/everymovieever. There, you can watch reviews of every movie we've ever covered here on the show, as well as complete episodes. That's northmetrotv.com/everymovieever.